Mr. Mohan, in your introductory remarks, you point out that there is nothing regarding the definition of backward classes. But in the Constituent Assembly, the question was asked, who are the backward classes? Dr. Ambedkar replied, backward classes are those who, in the opinion of the respective provincial government, are backward. That means Dr. Ambedkar put the responsibility of fixing the backwardness and the executive. But in the Mandal case, that responsibility was directly or indirectly taken over by the Supreme Court, fixing this crimi layer. The judiciary is not at all having any right to fix and say the crimi layer should be excluded from the orbit of preservation. That was a calculated conspiracy to avoid the crimi layer from the benefits of preservation from the backward classes. The result is that I was pointing it out the very day of that judgment. The vocal section of the backward classes should not have any interest in reservation. That was the calculated conspiracy. And the so-called organizations of the backward classes, the leadership, they are also now coming from this crimi layer. So they are also not fighting. That is the pathetic situation which we are facing today. So Dr. Mohan Gopal, Isharaya, Joshi, whoever may be now, Mahabodhi, whoever may be fighting for this issue, it is not only a legal issue, it is not only a issue of this backward classes and the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, it is a political, socio-political issue. The bet should be on two fronts. One is the legal bet, other is a socio-political bet. You know, when this proposal for this reservation on the basis of the economic backwardness was presented in Lok Sabha, even those political parties claimed to be the champion of the backward classes in their respective states, they kept mum. They didn't alter any bed, only 2-3 members voted against it. How it was introduced? It was introduced when this Lok Sabha was on, the parliament was on session. One day, the cabinet met and decided. The agenda which was circulated on that day for the next day, it was not mentioned. When the Lok Sabha was on its session, it was circulated as an additional agenda. Even the political parties, the members of parliament, didn't get time. What is it? To go through, what is it? The next day, it was passed by Rajya Sabha also, where this then opposition was having a majority. Even the champions, so-called champions of the backward classes, the political parties represented them, they didn't alter a word against it. Then it was sent to president, and president approved it. The political parties and the governments are competing each other to implement that economic backward. Justice Isharaya, Dr. Mohan Gopal, all of you may be knowing it. even if this economic reservation of the economic on the basis of the economic burden is unconstitutional. The constitution never envisaged it. Now it is in the Supreme Court. I don't know what they may decide. Because that you, as Mamboji was trying to point out, all of us may be aware, after KG Balakrishnan, there was not a single judge from the scheduled caste scheduled tribe in the Supreme Court. Even in the high courts, no Chief Justice, you can't see up to this after 73 years. Chief Justice of any of these high court from the backward classes or the the SCSTs. This is the situation. So what I was trying to point out is that anyway, a political decision was taken. This reservation on the basis of the economic backwardness was implemented. I am 100% against it. But even that, this economic backward sections from the scheduled caste, the economic backward sections from the socially and educationally backward communities, they are excluded. If there is a reservation for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, there is a reservation for the social and education backward classes from 1993 onwards. But this didn't mean that the economic backward sections, the poor sections among the backward classes, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes are getting the benefit of that reservation. When a reservation is implemented on the basis of the economic backwardness, it should be implemented without considering the caste, whether they are SCSTs, the social and economic backward caste. But nobody is pointing out this irregularity. That means, yes, when a new legislation is passed, a new proposal is implemented. If we are avoiding the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and the social education from that, when we get that proposal, that means it is a proposal for those people who believe in Chaturvarnya. Actually, Sangubhapar is for Chaturvarnya. So they are trying to link the country. The Chaturvarnya system should be mobilized. There's Muslim minorities as a social movement. Recently, we heard about it like that. Next 3 years, we should be in a position at the national level to mobilize scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, backward class. Fascist governance. We should get this as a challenge in the birthday of great Ambedkar. As all of us may be aware, when the freedom struggle was going on, when the round table conference was in the offing, Mahatma Gandhi never could not consider this that is the SCSTs, untouchables, out of the Hindu society. A right question was asked by Dr. Ambedkar. Those who are not having any place in the Chaturvarnya system society, which is considered as the Brahmini, as the ideal system. Mahatma Gandhi said, then this round table conference was in the there. Mahatma Gandhi tried to convince Dr. Ambedkar. There was a lot of interactions between them, Mahatma Gandhi and Dr. Ambedkar, Mani Bhavan in Bombay. They could not come to an agreement. Then Mahatma Gandhi approached Muhammad Ali Jinnah, getting support in the round table. He was not ready to give the support. Then there was this, the British Prime Minister was authorized to issue an award as an arbitrator. That was the communal award. Mahatma Gandhi undergone, passed unto death. Rightly, Dr. Ambedkar asked a question. You have declared your life for the freedom of this country. Up to this moment, you never declared an unto past for the freedom of this country. I know this communal rights between the Hindus and Muslims are threatening your mind, but you never declared an past unto death for stopping the rights, communal rights between the Hindus and Muslims. He did in 1948 after Birla. But up to that, Mahatma Gandhi could not answer. But he was there. He has gone to Yerathwada prison because Ambedkar believed that Mahatma Gandhi's life was valuable. So he surrendered. Then there was agreement, Pune Pact. The next day onwards, till his death in 1956, December 6th, he was repeatedly telling that I have committed a mistake. Now, who are there in the parliament, in the assemblies, representing the untouchables, the Dalits? They are trying to appease the other sections of the society, the parvid gods. Such people are being elected in the I don't know whether it is a reality or a legend which is being told in the northern India regarding Dr. Ambedkar. In 1947, 46, when we were marching towards freedom, a foreign journalist came to Delhi to meet the national leaders to have interview with them. First, he has gone to meet Mahatma Gandhi. It was too late. He reached Delhi late. He was sleeping. He could not meet him. Then he has gone to meet Pandit Nehru. He was also gone to sleep. He could not meet him. Other national leaders, he could not meet. Then he has gone to meet Dr. Ambedkar. Even at that midnight, Dr. Ambedkar was there, making notes. Then this journalist asked Dr. Ambedkar, all others have slept, even the Delhi has slept. Why you are here in the midst of books and making notes? Then he replied, even though Mahatma Gandhi has gone to sleep, Pandit Nehru has gone to sleep, and all other national leaders, they are representing the people who are always kept themselves blackened. But I am representing the people who are for centuries slept. For them I am here to going into the books and taking note. That was Dr. Ambedkar. Either as I have suggested, That is, the backward classes and the Muslim minorities should come together in this country at national life and have a movement, new movement, socio-political movement. Otherwise, there should be an emancipator like Dr. Ambedkar should come back. With these words, I conclude, expressing my homage to that great man, Dr. Ambedkar.